big problem that a lot of players have. They want to get better at their game, but they don't have a way to practice at home, and they are stuck at home and they don't have a hoop. Is there a way to get better? Absolutely. Coach Jesse Minchu at Get Handles, where I show you how to play like the pros and beyond so you can reach your dreams. Make sure you click that subscribe button so you catch the newest videos every Wednesday, Thursday, and Saturday to help you improve your game. Now, how do you practice at home to get better without a hoop? Well, first of all, for your handles, there's a ton of things you can do. You don't need a hoop to get better at your handles. You can practice stationary dribbling drills, you know, working on different combos stationary, even bringing a little footwork in. You could do things sitting down. But let's say you're stuck in your house and you don't even have a hoop. Is there something you can do for that? Yep, there is. Click this link right here. That's a YouTube video that I got for you. That's gonna show you three ways to improve your handles at home. It's gonna go much more in depth than I am in this video because I wanna cover all the skills I can in this video. But click that link and that video is gonna show you some ways to help you improve your handles even if you can't dribble and use a basketball. You can absolutely improve your handles even without a basketball. Okay, let's talk shooting. What can you do to improve your shooting at home? Well, one thing you can do is what I just did there, right? Just shooting the basketball right up, catching it, and getting reps in like that. But there's a lot of other things you can do, some unique drills that you can put into the mix to work on your shooting off the catch, off the dribble, right? These are all little details you need to start thinking about if you want to become a great basketball player. Just shooting like this over and over and over, that can help you, but you also need to work on your shooting off the catch, off the dribble, different footwork combinations, all that. Click the link right here. That's another YouTube video I got showing you a bunch of different shooting drills, five shooting drills you can do at home. They're gonna help you improve your shooting form, your footwork, and all these little details that I just covered that you need to have if you wanna be a great shooter in games, and you don't need a hoop for a single one of those drills. Next thing I got for you is one you probably didn't see coming, and it's something that can improve your entire game on offense, passing the basketball, catching the basketball, dribbling the basketball, shooting the basketball, anything with the basketball. Know what it is? It's your grip, okay? If you can work on your ability to grip the basketball and palm the basketball, everything you do is more controlled, more precise. Your shot percentage goes up. Your dribbles are more effective, more controlled, more quick, more powerful. Same with your passes and your catches, right? All because you improve your grip over the basketball. So how can you improve your grip and maybe even be able to palm a basketball? I actually had a player that I worked with that he was in fourth grade at the time, going into fifth, about average size hands, smaller than mine, and I can palm the basketball so on a good day, pretty good, you know, right now. But this kid had much smaller hands than me and was able to palm a basketball, and it made a big impact in his entire game. Click this link right here though, I'll show you exactly the drills I had him doing to get that kind of grip on the basketball and got him palming the basketball. Not all the time, but he could palm it from time to time pretty well, but click that link, that'll show you the drills that I had him doing, and that's gonna help you improve your entire offense, everything you're doing when you got the basketball in your hands. Next thing I got for you is the most overlooked aspect of basketball. The last thing we just talked about with gripping the basketball, I told you how that affects everything you're doing on offense, right? Every time you're touching the basketball. Well, what's something that would affect even more than that? What's something you use on offense, defense, rebounding, everything? It's your feet. No one really likes to think about their footwork, but your ability to move quickly, improve your athleticism, your precision with your feet, your power, all that is huge. It affects your shot. It affects your first step, your ability to change direction, self-face, your ability to move quickly on defense, your ability to rebound the basketball. You gotta have footwork, and this is something you could easily work on at home. Click the link right here. That's another YouTube video I got for you showing you five footwork drills that you can use. Those are gonna help you a ton with getting quicker with your footwork, getting different footwork patterns down, being more explosive, and just being a more athletic player on offense, defense, everything, you name it. It's gonna help you improve your game. Click that link, check it out. You can do all those drills at home. Okay, finally, layups. How do you improve your layups at home? This one I don't have a video to link you to. I'm actually gonna show you. So a couple things you can do. Number one, working on your footwork. I've worked with so many players, especially younger players, that always have a hard time with either travel or take the wrong steps with their weak hand. I like to call it the ace hand, so I'm a lefty. I'm gonna show you with my right hand. But just simply taking the time to slow down and going one, two, jump. Just getting reps of that. If you have a bunch of space, a sidewalk that you can work down, you could do it like that, or you could just do that going back and forth. Jump, one, two, jump, right? Dribble, one, two, jump. Just getting repetitions of that in can actually help you a ton. Doing it with both hands. Now, some things you can focus on to get more benefit out of it is work on one, two, jump, and try to jump extra high, right? Try to get as high in there as you can to work on your athleticism a little bit. That can help you a lot, and work on your ball control. You can also work on when you get into the air now doing different things with the basketball in the air to help improve your finishing around the rim, just to get your body control down. Then one final thing, a third thing you can do to help improve is if you have a line to work with, just go 1-2 jump and try to get it to land right on the line. Should be pretty easy if you're in control, but that'll get you better control over your body, more precision. So then when you do get a hoop to work with, you can start to get, you know, those layups going in more often. Now, if you want to really improve your ability to score around the rim, there's three big problems that a lot of players have that are keeping from scoring around the rim. And if you fix these three problems and start working on them, applying them to these drills I just showed you, it'll help you a ton. Now, to find out what those three big problems are, just click the link that you're seeing in the description down below, the top link, pop your email, I'll send that to you instantly for free. That'll instantly help you improve your scoring around the rim. Now, if you found this video helpful, also make sure you click that subscribe button and get on that notification squad so you can catch the newest videos the second they come out. And leave me a comment down below. Let me know if there's anything else you want to see from the channel. I get a ton of ideas from you guys, so leave me a comment and let me know. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for more and make moves today.